Hey, my name is Zeb, and I'm gonna read the Sonic.exe creepypasta story. I'm a total Sonic the Hedgehog fan, much like everyone else. I like the newer games, but I don't mind playing the classics. I don't think I've ever played glitchy or hacked games before. Though I don't think I want to play any after the experience I had. It started on a nice summer afternoon. I was playing Sonic Unleashed. I like how you get to explore the town in it. Until I noticed out of my peripheral vision that the mailman had arrived with something in my mailbox as usual and left. I paused my game to go see what I got in the mail. The only thing in the mailbox was a CD case for computers and a note. I took it inside. I looked at the note first and realized it was from my dear friend Kyle. Let's just call him that. Whom I haven't heard from in 2 weeks. I know that because I recognized his handwriting, but what was weird is how it looked. It looked badly written and scratchy and somewhat difficult to read, as if Kyle was having a hard time writing down and did it in a hurry. This is what he wrote. Tom, I can't take it anymore. I had to get rid of this thing somewhere before it was too late, and I was hoping you'd do it for me. I can't do it. He's after me, and if you just don't destroy this CD, he's coming after you too. He's too fast for me. Please, Tom, destroy this godforsaken disc before he comes after you too. It's too late for me. Destroy the disc, and you destroy him. But do it quick, otherwise he'll catch you. Don't even play the game. It's what he wants. Just destroy it. Please! Kyle. Well, that was certainly weird. Even though Kyle is my best friend, and I haven't seen him in 2 weeks, I didn't do what he asked me. I didn't think that a simple gaming disc would do anything bad to him. After all, it's just a game, right? Boy, was I wrong about that. Anyway, I looked at the disc, and it looks like any ordinary computer CDR disc, except it had black marker on it written Sonic.exe, and was much unlike Kyle's handwriting, meaning that he must have gotten it from someone else, like a pawn shop or eBay. When I saw Sonic on the writing of the CD, I was actually excited and wanted to play it, since I'm a big Sonic fan. I went to my room and turned on my PC and put the disc in. Installed the game. When the title screen popped up, I noticed that it was the first Sonic game. I was like, awesome! Because like I said earlier, I like the classics. The first thing I noticed that was out of place was when I pressed start. There was a split second when I saw the title turned into something much different, something that I now consider horrifying, before cutting to black. I remember what the image looked like in that split second before the game cut to black. The sky had darkened. Title emblem was rusty and ruined. The Sega 1991 was now instead Sega 666, and the water had turned red like blood, except it looked hyper realistic. But the freakiest thing was in that split second frame was Sonic. His eyes were pitch black and bleeding, the two glowing red dots staring right at me, and his smile had stretched wider up the edge of his face. I was rather disturbed about that image when I saw it. Though I figured that it was just a glitch and forgot about it. After it cut to black, it stayed like that for about 10 seconds or so. And then another weird thing happened. The save file selected from Sonic the Hedgehog 3 popped up. And I was like, what the fuck? What's this doing in the first Sonic game? Anyway, then I noticed something off. The background was a dark cloudy sky from the Bad Dust Speedway level from Sonic CD. And there were only 3 save files. The music was the creepy caverns of winter music from Earthbound, only it was extended and seemed to have been in reverse. And the image for the save file where you see a preview of the level you're on is just red static for all 3 files. What's freaking me out was the character select. It showed only Tails, Knuckles and, to my surprise, Dr. Robotnik. Now I was sure that something was up. I mean, how can you play as Robotnik in the classic Sonic for crying out loud? That's when I realized that this wasn't a glitch game, it was a hacked game. Yeah, it definitely looked hacked. It was really creepy, but as a smart gamer, I wasn't scared, or at least I tried not to be. I told myself that it was just a hacked game, there's nothing wrong with that. Anyways, shaking off the creeped out feeling, I picked file 1 and chose Tails, and when I selected and got started, the game froze for about 5 seconds, and I heard a creepy pixelated laugh. That sounded an awful lot like that Kefka guy from Final Fantasy before cutting to black. The screen stayed black for about 10 seconds more than it showed the typical level title thing, except the simplistic shapes were different shades of red, and the text showed only Hill, Act 1, The screen faded in, and the level title vanished, revealing Tails in the Green Hill Zone from Sonic 1. His music was different though, it sounded like a peaceful melody in reverse. Anyway, I started playing and had Tails start running like you would in any of the classic Sonic games. What was odd was that Tails was running along the level. There was nothing but flat ground and a few trees for 5 minutes. That was when the peaceful music started to lower down into slow, deep tones. Very slow as I kept going. I suddenly saw something and stopped to see what it was. It was one of the small animals lying dead on the ground bleeding. That was when the music started to slow down. Tails had a shocked and sad look on his face that I never saw from him before. So I had him move along and he kept that worried look on his face. As he kept moving, I saw more dead animals as Tails passed, looking more and more worried. As the music lowers and he moves past more dead animals, I was shocked to see how they all died. They looked like somebody killed them in rather gruesome ways. A squirrel was hanged on a tree with what happened to be his entrails hanging out. A bunny had all of his limbs torn off, and a duck had his eyes gouged out and his throat slit. I felt sick to my stomach when I saw this massacre, and apparently so did Tails. After more seconds, there were no more animals and the music seemed to have stopped. I still kept Tails to continue. After a minute had passed, after the music stopped, Tails was running up a hill and stopped. It wasn't until I saw why. Standing there on the other side of the screen with his back against Tails and with his eye closed, Tails looked happy to see Sonic, but then his mouth fluttered, obviously noticing that Sonic wasn't responding to him, if not acting as if he was totally oblivious of Tails' presence. Tails walked slowly towards Sonic and noticed that I wasn't even moving my keyboard to make a move. This had to have been a cutscene. Suddenly I began to have grown feel of dread as Tails walked closer to Sonic to get his attention. I felt that Tails was in danger and something bad was going to happen. That faint static growing louder as Tails was but an inch away from Sonic and stopped and stuck his hand out to touch him. That foreboding feeling in my guts was growing stronger, felt the urge to tell Tails to get away from Sonic as the static grew louder. Suddenly, in a split second, I saw Sonic's eyes open, and they were black, with those red glowing dots, just like that title image. But there wasn't a smile. When that happened, the screen turned black, and the static sound was off. It stayed black for about 7 seconds, and then white text appeared, forming a message, saying, "Hello, do you want to play with me?" At this point, I was creeped out. I didn't want to continue with the game, but my curiosity got the better of me. When I was taken to a different level with the level title now saying Hide and Seek. This time I was in the Angel Island level from Sonic 3 and it looked like everything was on fire. Tails looked as though he was scared out of his wits this time. He actually looked at me and made frantic gestures to me as if he wanted to get out of the area he was in as fast as possible. I was starting to get freaked out by this. I mean, Tails was actually breaking the fourth wall, trying to tell me to get him out of there. So I pressed down the arrow key as hard as I could, made him run as fast as he could. A pixelated version of that creepy theme when Matt Shadow at the arc as Robotnik from Sonic Adventures 2 was playing as I made Tails streak through the desolated forest, trying to get him escape from whatever he was trying to run from. Suddenly I heard that creepy laugh again, that awful Kafka laugh. Right after 10 seconds have passed, as I helped Tail run through the forest, and I started seeing flashes of Sonic popping everywhere on the screen, again with those black and red eyes. The music changed to that suspenseful drowning jingle as I see Sonic behind Tails slowly gaining up on him, flying. Sonic wasn't running, he was actually flying. The flying pose of his sprite was making him look very similar to Metal Sonic's flying pose in Sonic CD, except it was just Sonic and he had the black and red eyes again. Only this time he had the most deranged looking grin on his face. He looked as though he was enjoying the torment he was giving the poor little fox as he gained up on him. Suddenly, when Tail tripped, another cutscene. The music stopped and Sonic vanished. Tail slayed there and started crying for 15 seconds. The scene was rather unsettling to watch, and I kinda teared up myself. But then Sonic appeared right in front of Tails, and Tails looked up in horror. Blood started to come out of those blackened eyes of Sonic's as a grin slowly grew from his face. And as he looked down at the horrified fox, I could do nothing but watch. Just in a split second, Sonic lunged at Tails right before the screen went black. There was a loud screeching noise that only lasted 5 seconds. The text returned, only this time it said, "You're too slow. Want to try again?" Then a god awful laugh came with it. I was so shocked by what had happened. Did Sonic murder Tails? No, he couldn't have. He and Tails are supposed to be best friends, right? Why did Sonic do that to him? I shook the shock off as I was brought back to the character select. The save file that had Tails was different. Tails was no longer in the box itself, but the TV screen itself, which was flickering with that red text. Tails' expression scared me. His eyes were black and bleeding. His orange fur had gone black and had an expression of anguish on his face. Trying to ignore it, I picked Knuckles next. The laugh came again, and the screen cut to black again. It stayed there for another 10 seconds. This time, the level said, "You can't run." I was really freaking out by now. I couldn't really tell if this was a glitch or a hack or some kind of sick twisted joke or anything really. But despite my fear of what happened next, I kept playing. The next level looked much different. It had the ground of Scrap Brain Zone, but the sky background looked like the main menu. It had a dark reddish cloudy sky, but it was the music that creeped me out the most. It sounded like Geiger's theme right after you beat Pokey and Earthbound. I also noticed that Knuckles looked afraid, just like Tails did, though not as much, more rather he looked a little unnerved. He broke the fourth wall, just like Tails, and looked as if he wasn't sure about going on, but I made him move anyway. He ran down the straight pathway in this dark level, and as he did, the screen started to flicker, red static a couple of times, and then that maddening laugh came again. Then after a few seconds of running, I noticed several bloodstains on the metallic ground. I felt a growing sense of fear again. Thinking something horrible is going to happen to Knuckles, he looked nauseated, walking down this bloodstained road, but I still kept him going. Suddenly, as Knuckles ran, Sonic appeared right in front of him, with those black and red eyes, and then red static appeared again, where the static vanished, showing nothing but black, with the screen saying, "Found you!" I was now scared. Sonic found Knuckles already? What was going on? Anyway, Red Stair came again, and then it was back to the level. Knuckles looked like he was panicking, and Sonic was nowhere to be found. And this time, that high-pitched squealing from the Silent Hill 1's final boss was playing. Was this some kind of boss battle with Sonic? I hope to God it wasn't, honestly. Suddenly, Sonic appeared right behind Knuckles. Was this some kind of boss battle with Sonic? I hope to God it wasn't, honestly. Suddenly, Sonic appeared right behind Knuckles, what appears to be pixelated black smoke. I made Knuckles turn and then punch Sonic, but Sonic vanished in black pixelated smoke if I could even land a hit. The terrible laugh went off again, then Sonic appeared behind Knuckles again, and I made him punch again, but Sonic vanished again, laughing. Knuckles was panicking even more, and even I felt like I was going crazy. Sonic was practically playing with us. He was playing a sick, twisted little mind game with me and Knuckles. Another cutscene played. Knuckles fell to his knees and clutched his head, sobbing. Felt his agony. Sonic was actually driving us both crazy. And then in a split second, Sonic lunged at Knuckles and the screen went to black. Another distorted screeching noise that lasted for at least 3 seconds. Another text appeared. "So many souls to play with. So little time. Wouldn't you agree?" What the hell? Just what is going on? I started to think that Sonic was actually trying to talk to me through the game, but I was too scared to think that. I was brought back to the main menu, and this time the second file box had Knuckles in the TV screen. His red fur had darkened to a reddish gray, his dreadlocks were dripping with blood, and his eyes were black and bleeding too, and he had a look of sadness on his face. I began to think that those are the actual characters trapped in those TV screens on the save file, but I couldn't believe it. I didn't want to believe it. So I shut off the game and took a break. I took a nap, which I hadn't, cause I began to have the most disturbing nightmare. I was in a pitch black darkness, though I was under the light giving off by a lamp, the tongue high above my head. I could hear the cries of Knuckles and Tails nearby. They were saying stuff like, "Help us," and "Why did you give us to him?" and run away before it gets you too. The cries died out as I heard Sonic laugh. His laugh, it sounded a lot like the distorted Kefka laugh.
You're a lot of fun to play with, kid, just like your friend Kyle.
Though he didn't last long, I was scared and looked around for the source of the voice.
It won't be long now until you join him and all my other friends.
I saw him walking towards me, flickering in and out several directions.
You can't run, kid. You're in my world now, just like the others.
When he grabbed me, I saw his bleeding black and red-eyed, grinning face. I woke up with a fright. After a couple of hours, I decided to continue playing the game. I don't know why, but I had to know. I had to figure out why this was happening. So I turned on the computer, turned on the game, and selected Robotnik next. I still thought that was wacky, playing as Robotnik. But anyway, the level title screen appeared again. And this time, it said dot dot dot, which I found really freaky. This time, I was in some kind of hallway. Didn't really look like it was from any of the classic Sonic games, though it was its pixelated style. The floor was shiny, checkered. The walls were dark grayish purple with animated candle lights and a few dark bloodstains here and there. And there was a dark red curtain hanging above the top part of the screen. Every 12 seconds or so, that red curtain sways very slowly, but whenever you're playing the game, you can barely see it move. The music was oddly pleasant, a piano playing a rather sad yet peaceful song, but I knew better. This was the song that played in Hill Act 1, only it wasn't in reverse. Robotnik didn't look entirely nervous like Tails and Knuckles, but he did have a suspicious look on his face, as if he was just a bit paranoid. He did a little animation when I just left him standing. He turns his head to the left and then to the right at least twice and shrugged at me, as if he has no idea where he was or what was going on. Even though I was scared out of my mind about what was going to happen, I had Robotnik continue onward. He did his usual running animation. You know, when you beat him at the end of a classic Sonic game, you chase him as we continued going through the hallway. Then I stopped a long flight of stairs leading downward. Now I was nervous, even Robotnik seemed unsure of himself, but I was pressing onward. And I led Robotnik down the stairs, and I noticed that the walls would have gone darker and more reddish. Red torches are now an eerie blue. Then we landed onto another hall. This one was longer than the last one, but at least it felt like it. And then we headed down another flight of stairs down. This one was much longer, took at least one full minute. And then I heard that horrid Kefka laugh again. And then the music slowly faded until it was quiet. As it did, the walls turned more dark red, and the torches were black flame now. When Robotnik landed onto the third hallway, I noticed he now looked really creeped out. Though he tried to hide it, I couldn't blame. I was scared too. Suddenly, Sonic popped right in front of Robotnik the same way he did Knuckles, and then red static. Red static lasted for about 15 seconds, and then it showed me a most unpleasant image. The image showed hyper-realistic of Sonic standing in the darkness, where you could only see his face, with his head and torso faded into black. And when I say hyper-realistic, I mean like he looked so real you could actually see the lines in his blue fur if you touch the screen. His face. Oh god, he had the most horrific smell I had ever seen. And that's saying something considering I saw the image at the start of the game. His eyes are white and black, and once again crying blood, which also looked hyper-realistic. And there were two small glowing red dots in those black eyes, staring right at me, as if staring into my mind. His grin was wide and demonic. It literally stretched to the sides of his face like a Cheshire cat, except Sonic had fangs. Very sharp fangs, much like the Werehog teeth, except more vicious looking, somewhat yellowish, and from the look of it, he had stains of blood and small bits of flesh on his lips and fangs as if he ate some animal. I stared at the gruesome image for a good 30 seconds, never taking my eyes off it. It felt as if he was actually looking at me, smiling at me. That face. It just took 10 seconds for it to etch itself into my brain for good. Then the screen flickered with the red static again, 3 times. On the third time, I heard the Kefka laugh, except this time it sounded distorted, demonic even. It went back to the image again, except this time there was the text again, though it was messed up, but it was pretty much one of the most horrific things I looked at since I had this game. I am God. It was when I read the text while looking at Sonic
When it hit me, I realized right there and then that Sonic was a monster. A pure evil, sadistic, all-powerful, nightmarish, demented monster. And all of his victims, including Tails, Knuckles, Robotnik, and possibly Kai, are just his little toys. And the game is a very gateway into his chaotic, nightmarish world. In the very hell his victims are trapped. Suddenly, in an actual split second, I screamed as Sonic lunged at the screen, screeching loudly, with his mouth wide open to an unnatural length, revealing nothing but a literal spiraling abyss of pure darkness before the red static came again, this time much louder and distorted, as loud as it hurts my ears. I yelled and grabbed my ears, as the static reached for a good 7 seconds. Then it stopped and showed nothing but black screen. As I sat there staring at the black screen, one last text came up.
Ready for round 2, Tom!
The Kefla laugh, now sounding more clear as if Sonic was right behind. Played again 3 times as I looked at that text in shock and confusion. Then I got booted back to the main menu, and this time, third save file had a TV image of Robotnik in the same tormented state as Tails and Knuckles. Robotnik's skin turned dull grey, his mustache dropped and had blacked, his glasses broke, and blood is coming from them, and he had a mere dead-like expression on his face. I looked at Tails, Knuckles and Robotnik, and I cried a bit. I pitied them for the agony they're going through. They were trapped forever within the game, forever tormented by that horrid hedgehog, and always will be. Then the computer shut itself off. I couldn't turn it back on no matter what I did. I sat there for maybe 25 seconds, horrified by what just happened. Sonic is the very embodiment of evil. He tortures people with who plays his game in more ways than one. And then, when he gets bored, he drags you into his game. Literally drags you to hell, where he can play with you always as his toy. I can't get the game out of my computer. I think it's stuck in there. At least I managed to turn back on now. I've sat there for 25 seconds, heard a voice right behind me, like a whisper.
Try to keep this interesting for me, Tom.
I turned around to see where the voice came from, and what I saw made me scream. Sitting on my bed, staring right at me, was a Sonic plushie, smiling with bloodstains under its eyes. And don't forget, we'll meet each other. I'll see you tomorrow.